Okay, so now we come to some more Wet n Wild, some Essence. I did find another NYX palette that I missed when I was first organizing some Koki palettes, and then a little Blink palette that I got in BoxyCharm. I'm actually not sure if Blink is drugstore or high-end, but it was sitting with my drugstore palette, so that is where we are counting it for the time being. In fact, let's actually start with that. This is the Blink BoxyCharm Electric Eyes palette. This is a really nice palette filled with really pretty sort of warm tone shimmer shades. These are actually beautiful shadows, but I have to be honest, I feel like I have them replicated in single shadows and kind of replicated in a ton of different palettes, so I don't necessarily find myself reaching for this palette over other things in my collection. Like, the colors in here aren't unique enough that I'm pulling for it. It is an all shimmer palette. This is not bad, but I am gonna go ahead and pass it on. I'm just not reaching for it. Another one that I think I'm gonna go ahead and pass on, this is from NYX. This is the Ultimate palette. This is in Cool Neutrals. I kept this for a while thinking I would reach for it because it did have a nice mix of cool colors in it. I like a good cool tone palette, but this one just wasn't inspiring me a ton. It's not to say the quality of these shadows is bad. There's definitely worse things from NYX out on the market. I would say the shadows in here are just average. I have heard people say that the warm palette in this is fantastic. I have not tried that one, but I'm just not reaching for this, and I feel like I've discovered other cool tone palettes that I enjoy more than this, so I'm gonna pass this one on as well, too. Two that I'm keeping because I am in the process of testing them. These are new from Koki. These are their Artist Eye palettes, and this is in the shade Treasured. So this is just a really interesting mix of colors that you don't typically see at the drugstore, so I was really fascinated to try these more jewel-toned shadows. And then this is their warm palette called Peachy Queen, and you can see, like, this is just a beautiful, beautiful peachy palette that I think is absolutely stunning. It's got a ton of mattes in it. I have not really played around a ton with Koki eyeshadows. I think I had gotten one palette from Walmart and was kind of unimpressed by it, but this seems to be a new formula. It's definitely new packaging. It feels very high-end, and so far, you know, just from finger swatches, I feel like these are going to be decent mattes at least. We'll see how the shimmers perform. I feel like it used to be the case where shimmers in drugstore palettes performed and then the mattes didn't, and I kind of feel like of late it's been reversed, and I feel like I've been finding decent matte shadows but not good shimmer shades. So I'm curious to see kind of how these perform, and, you know, if they end up with lots of fading, because that seems to be my one problem with some of the drugstore ones that I have tried. They can go on really pretty, but then they have a tendency to fade on you. I don't know, just from swatches, I think there's going to be some hits and misses, but it, as with any palette, you really need to put it on your eyes with brushes and how you would apply it versus just finger swatches to get a scent. You know, in general, I was really impressed with the packaging, the design, and just the interesting colors that Koki's put together here, so I'm going to hang on to both of these, try them. This may be something that I end up decluttering after I give my review to you guys, but a review for these is coming. All right, I have two Essence palettes here. This is All About Nudes. This one's been out for a while. It's just a little 8-pan palette. And then this is All About Toffee. And I thought Toffee was going to be a really nice sort of cool tone version of this. I actually find this to be a really pretty palette. It is mostly mattes with one sort of shimmery satin shade down here. It's got a smidge bit of glitter in it, but it's not too like fallouty as far as glitter goes. But these mattes are actually really buttery and really smooth and easy to apply. It just gives a really sort of soft, I don't know, really pretty soft effect on the eye. So I really have been a fan of this All About Nudes palette. The All About Toffee palette isn't bad, but for some reason I just don't love it as much as the All About Nudes one. I think it's just because I'm not getting a ton of depth. I don't know. Like, I like cool tone palette. You guys have probably heard me say this, but I don't know. This one's just not necessarily doing it for me. So I do think I'm going to keep the All About Nudes one. I'm going to pass on the Toffee one. Okay, so these last five are the Wet n Wild palettes. These are their new 10-pan palettes that they put out for spring, and this is the old version of one of them. I used to have the purple version of this, but I actually decluttered it in my last drugstore declutter, the one that I deleted all the footage of. Yay me. So let's start here. This is the old Comfort Zone palette, and I really have loved this. I think as far as finding really great, fun colors for lids, this definitely had it. This blue-brown shade is absolutely stunning. Just really great quality for the drugstore. Super creamy formula. Loved this green on the lid. Just made some really interesting looks with it. I never really used this palette on its own, but it was a really beautiful pairing palette. So I definitely loved this palette, would have recommended it highly. So I love conceptually what they did here. They took the original palette and added two transition shades. And the two transition shades in the new Comfort Zone palette are beautiful. You've got this sort of rusty red color, and you've got a really nice sort of orangey brown color. I think that these are great transition shades for this. My biggest challenge with this is I just don't feel like the formulas are the same. In fact, they aren't. They say new formula. The new formula isn't bad, but it's just, it doesn't have this soft sort of buttery texture. And I just feel like, I don't know. I mean, the shades are similar. They're not so far off that I hate them. I don't know. I'm torn on these palettes because I really wish that they had just kept this formula and did what they did here with the transition shades. Some shades I think perform the same. Some shades I think perform better. Some shades I think are totally different. This green is really pretty, but it's darker and more olivey than the old shade. I don't know. I like the old shade a little bit better. So I'm going to be doing a more in-depth review of all of these palettes, but I can't bring myself to keep both of these. That feels incredibly redundant. And this isn't a palette that you can get anymore. I am going to go ahead and pass this one on and keep this one. This is Rosé in the Air. This is a new palette for them. It's definitely duping Modern Renaissance Land. I have done a couple really pretty looks with this, and I actually really do enjoy it. I think it is a lot more compact and a little more travel friendly, honestly, than Modern Renaissance. So, you know, not having an old formula to compare to with this, I can really just let this one stand on its own. And I will have to admit, I do like this one. This is the Not a Basic Peach palette. This one was a little disappointing to me, honestly. I just felt like the shimmers were not what I was hoping they would be. They were just a little patchy. So like, you see how that shimmer just was super creamy and smooth, and this one just looks powdery. There's something slightly funky with the shimmer shades in here that was even different than the ones that were in here. So this is one I'm going to keep for review purposes, but heads up, I will be decluttering it after that. And then this is Nude Awakening. I believe these were colors that were in a different style palette that they had put out. This one's not bad to me. It's definitely leans a little more smoky. There's not as much variation between some of these shades, but I will say that the shimmer shades feel more like the ones that were in the Comfort Zone palette than the peach one. They actually have a nice metallic sheen to them, and I've actually been able to make some very pretty looks with this palette, so I have enjoyed the colors in here. I like the more rosier pinky shades that are in here. I don't know, I would have done the color scheme just slightly different and probably not done four dark shades here. I would have given a little bit of more mid-tone variety. That's what I feel like is missing in here, unfortunately. All right, now let's talk about some drugstore palettes that you can only purchase off of websites. So we're talking about things like Juvia's Place and Coastal Scents and Crown. This is Kiko Milano. This, I know they have a few stores throughout the US, but the majority of us won't have a store near us where we can pick up any of these products. Let's start here. This is the Crown palette. This was the Glam Metals palette. This came in a BoxyCharm. It was sort of grungy rocker colors. I was kind of unimpressed by this, to be totally honest. I'm fine with palettes that need another palette in order to work appropriately. This desperately needed some transition shades. The colors themselves felt kind of like they had a mineral oil base in them, but unlike some of the Juvia's Place palettes, I found these kind of hard to work with. They're pretty with a finger swatch, don't get me wrong, but I think both from a color perspective as well as just a, I don't know, overall, just do I love this palette? This one never really like called to me. Quality wasn't bad. I mean, like I said, it was a decent palette. It's just not one of my favorite, not one I'm going to see myself reaching for, so I'm going to pass this one along. All right, this little Kiko Milano palette, I've not tried a lot of eyeshadows from them, and this one kind of caught me off guard. This is their Smart palette 02. I think this is, it says it's a Smart Cult eyeshadow palette. I'm gonna have to look this up, and I'll put the actual name that's on their website here for you guys. But the jewel tones in this are really pretty, and I thought, I didn't have a lot of jewel tone palettes, and I was curious about Kiko eyeshadows. See, I think I tried a couple singles from them and a couple cream products from them, but I've never tried one of their eyeshadow palettes. So this one is new to my collection, and I have swatched it, but I have not played with it yet. I've been testing a lot of like actual new drugstore palettes, so I don't have a huge opinion for you yet, other than to say I thought these looked really pretty when I did swatch them. They seemed to be really foiled and it looked like they were going to blend onto the skin really easily. I thought they felt kind of interesting. Didn't feel like any other eyeshadows that I had in my collection. They looked pretty foiled and nice. So nice mixtures of sort of nude shades as well as some bolder colors. But yeah, I just need to get through some of my drugstore eyeshadow palettes that I'm reviewing so that I can turn my sights to this guy. This is a Coastal Scents Revealed palette. This is the Revealed Matte palette. I don't have any of the other Revealed palettes. I know these were popular on YouTube several years ago, but I think they were kind of duping a lot of Urban Decay eyeshadow palettes. And this one kind of is doing the same thing. It's duping the Urban Decay, what was it, the Ultimate Naked Basics, I think it was, that square rose gold palette. But I think this palette has some of the same problems that Urban Decay palette does, which is they have a ton of sort of light tones here, and then it immediately jumps to deep tones. So rather than having a variety of mid-tones to light to dark and different interesting colors in between, I kind of feel like this one went and copied the Urban Decay one and copied all of its bad faults as well. I mean, the shadows always were creamy to me. I mean, I didn't really have any problem applying any of these shades. I look at this palette and I'm like, I don't need 32 different taupe shades. You know what I mean? So I don't know. I think I'm going to pass this one along. These are the three Juvia's Place palettes that I own. I think these are the only three that really interested me. They have some really fun colors in different palettes, but these are the ones that I thought I would get the most use out of. So this is the Nubian palette. This was her original palette. This one is kind of your classic warm toned palette. It's got nice mattes and deeper tones. I do know that these are brands that were designed for women with deeper skin tones. So I certainly appreciate the fact that there isn't like a brow bone shade for a pale person like me, and that the transition shades they're using are meant for someone with a deeper complexion. So I do recognize that, and I appreciate that there's a brand who's kind of using that as a filter as opposed to just always pasty white girl as like their prime example. I do recognize though that when I use this palette, I will probably have to reach for something that's a little bit of a lighter shade as a transition. That being said, these colors are lovely. I haven't played around with this one a ton. This is actually the second palette that I bought from them. I've used it several times and the colors are definitely super pigmented. Like, you can't argue with the pigmentation on this palette. But I also picked this up when I was in the process of testing a bunch of other eyeshadow palettes. So I will admit, I did two or three looks with it, really liked what I got at from the looks perspective, and then it kind of went in my drawer and hasn't gotten a lot of love. So the quality on this is unbelievable. The quality of all the Juvia's Place palettes, in my opinion, is incredible. So I'm hoping now that I reach for this a little bit more as I've edited down my collection a smidge, and I'm gonna be doing some things to make sure that I am pulling in eyeshadow palettes into a rotation on a regular basis. We'll talk about that in a future video. But that being said, I am keeping this. So these two, this is the Masquerade palette. This is their mini palette. They do a Masquerade palette that is apparently enormous and it's like double the size of this. These are like normal eyeshadow pans, and my understanding is the other ones are probably double the size of it. To me, this was plenty. But this is such a good, colorful palette. If you are looking to play with color, this is a great way to pull it in at a really affordable price, because this group knows how to do color like nobody's business. I don't even need to say anything, do I? I mean, is that not the most beautiful pigmentation you have ever seen? If you are looking for some bright colors, this is a palette I would absolutely recommend. I have loved playing with these purples. This is a really pretty matte sort of fuchsia color, which actually works as a fantastic blending shade for actually any of these colors up here. This sort of blended up and through the crease and one of these colors on the lid looks amazing. These pair well together, the purples, the blues, just gorgeous. And then if you want to pull in more neutrally looks down here as transition shades, or even just as pairing shades with this, these make beautiful liners, beautiful colors under the lid, gorgeous colors, just absolutely stunning pigmentation. They last on your eyes. If you want color in your collection, but you don't feel like you're going to reach for it a ton, Juvia's Place palettes are the way to go, because it's going to give you the most beautiful, vibrant colors you would ever wish for, but at a really affordable price. And then this is the Deuce palette. I think that's how you say this. This is a newer palette to their collection. And I just thought the colors in here were so, so inspiring. I mean, so basically you've got five mattes, so in the corners and in the middle, and then you've got these four shimmer shades. I don't know. For some reason, I look at this and I just feel so inspired. Once again, the quality is there just like on their past palettes. I mean, absolutely incredible pigmentation, high foil shine. And then you've got these really fun matte colors that I just thought were so much, I don't know, so interesting, so bright. I just got this a few days ago, so I have not had a chance to play around with it, but I've been eyeing it for quite a while off of their website, so I'm super excited to have it here and see that the colors are every bit as gorgeous and fun to swatch and to play with as I thought they would be. So I'm really excited to play around with some fun looks with this. So clearly hanging on to this.